there was the movie, Ghost of Mississippi, with Whoopi Goldberg, when Whoopi Goldberg played Mega Evers' wife. And I think it was one of the Baldwins played the lawyer. Right, Alec Baldwin, one of them played the lawyer that was fighting the case for Mega Evers' murder.
We have to go digging up things that happened 25 years ago anyway.
You persecute a 70-year-old man over some nigger, you'll have everybody in the state of Mississippi lined up against you.
25 years ago, I was on the witness stand and I watched as the former governor of this state shook hands with the man who murdered my husband.
Are you admitting to me that you
killed Mega Evers? What if I did? It's not like there's anything you nor anybody else can do about it. Yes, sir.
And there was a scene in the movie where Alec Baldwin's wife told him, she said, "You're not going to change the world." And he said, "Well, I became a lawyer because I can change the world one case at a time." Right. And she said, "You're not going to change the world." That was an interesting movie because as much as he tried to bring the killers of Mega Evers to justice, he had all this racial tension against him from white people in Mississippi, because you're not going to change the world. That's what this devil is saying right here. You're not going to change the world. You're not. The Most High already put that division between Israel and the nations. Go to Sirach, Ecclesiastes 17:17. The Most High already put that division. You're not going to change it. And that hatred, the Most High said, your enemies, Leviticus, that scripture is the Lord telling Moses the curses we would go through from the beginning. He said, they that hate you would rule over you. So it would never, he's telling her, this so-called black Mexican young modern day woman that thinks she can change the world. That's old Edomite racism. He's saying, look, you're not going to change it. So go to Sirach 17 and 17. Read that.
Ecclesiastes chapter 17, verse 17. For in the division of the nation of the whole earth.
No, in a unifying.
For in the division of the nations of the whole earth.
Yeah, the Lord divided the nations from the beginning. Yeah, we would live and coexist, but we would be separated as people with culture, language, the way we look. Right? And most nations, even on the earth today, even though you have increase of racial dating and marriage amongst Israel, but most nations today, they partial to their own people. Right? And the Most I said it was going to go back to that. Read on Ecclesiastes 17:17 again.
Ecclesiastes chapter 17, verse 17. For in the division of the nations of the whole earth, he set a ruler over every people.
So the Lord said he already divided the nations. No matter what you do, you can't bring them together. That's what this devil is saying right here. He's actually speaking in the spirit. He's speaking scripture now. This devil is uttering scripture, even though he's not quoting a book, a chapter and a verse, but he's speaking in the spirit. He's speaking the way the Most High made. Go ahead.
But Israel is the Lord's portion.
But out of all the nations that's divided, Israel is the Lord's portion. Right, come on.
Whom, being his firstborn, he nourished and with discipline.
Because he gave us the law. It said he nourished us. Right? With discipline, he gave us the law. Come on.
And giving him the light of his love, doeth not forsake him.
So even though the so-called white man hate our people's guts, and the feeling is mutual, Sterling, right, Jew boy Sterling, the feeling is mutual. I don't give a damn if you hate. I want you white people to show your true hatred.
That's right.
Stop being phony.
Right.
So we can identify our enemy and some of our people that's simple
and
want to be knuckleheads and keep following you and can't wake up. They can see how you really feel.
Right.
That's why the Lord said he will give every needful thing in due season. He going to show you Negroes in due season how this man really feel about you in 2014, even though he allowed you to run up and down a damn basketball court.
Right,
go ahead.
Therefore, all their works.
Oh, that's it on that. So the Lord is letting us know in the division of all the nations. Right, give me Isaiah 13. And this is prophecy coming to pass. Right, my man Sterling telling the truth.
Rose up.
Right, we ought to buy Sterling a drink.
Right.
What's Sterling drinking tonight, man? maybe we can go downtown LA and find him somewhere. He might be in a bar or something. The niggas find out how I really felt about him.
Right.
Let's go downtown LA and find Sterling, man.
He can drop us some more jewels.
Right. And we're gonna pat Sterling on the back and say, Sterling, what you drinking tonight,
right,
man? Right, and get him drunk so he can tell us some more stuff. By shooting my shot, So let's get Isaiah chapter 13 and let me see what I want. Isaiah 13, 14.
Isaiah chapter 13, verse 14.
Come on.
And it shall be as the chaste robe.
And that's what this is going to lead to. This really going to lead up. The Most High letting stuff like this happen also to spark the race war. This could be like little triggers to lead up to the race war. Come on.
As a sheep that no man taketh up.
Come on.
They shall every man turn to his own people and flee every one into his own land.
There you go. See that? He said it. I don't want to change the culture because I can't.
That's right.
It's too big and too much of a separation. He didn't say that there, but every man gonna turn to their own people. So really, he keeping it real with
him. Out of his power.
It's out of his power. He said, look, it don't matter even if I felt like you.
Right.
But he said, I don't want to change it. And one of the reasons, he's really speaking wisdom here. One of the reasons why he say, I don't want to change it, because I can't if I wanted to.
Right.
So I might as well deal with it the way it is.
Right. It's his kingdom.
It's his kingdom. He being a realist.
That's right.
Right? We going to find Sterling tonight. Sterling downtown at the L.A. bar getting drunk, man.
We're going to
find that money. Find that man. What you drinking tonight, Sterling? So he can give us some more secrets.
Right.
He can say some more stuff. Go ahead.
Verse 15. Everyone that is found shall be thrust through.
Come on.
And everyone that is joined unto them.
And Miss Stiviano here, she better get the hell away from Sterling in these last days. Come on.
Shall fall by the sword.
Right, because she's either Judah or Issachar, so she better separate. Unless some way, somehow, her father's a Mexican Spaniard.
Right.
And, you know, that's the only way. Or her father's a Judite tear.
Right.
Or, you know, a Negro tear. You know, either way. But, you know, she's supposed to be black or Mexican, so either she's Judah or Issachar. So you better get the hell away from Staviano. I mean, from Sterling. Right, go ahead.
Verse 16. Their children also shall be dashed to pieces before their eyes.
Come on.
Their houses shall be spoiled, and their wives ravished.
And the race was, that's what's going to happen to Esau. The way they ravished our women, like they tell you in Lamentations, the 5th chapter.
Right.
They ravished the daughters of Zion.
Right.
Even though now they don't have to rap. They don't have to rape you now. You black women are just going to them by the busloads.
Right.
And you black men, you run into the white women by the busloads. It is a curse on all our nation.
That's right. That's right.
But in these race wars, this is what the Lord said happened. And the main point I want it is every man going to turn to their own people.
Right.
So right here, he's let Sterling say, look, you can't change it no matter what. Right. So let's all finish this out. The extended audio. Right?
Dude. I don't want to change your mind. You're okay. I can do what I want. I don't want the girl. I'll find a girl that will do what I want.
Uh-huh. Go ahead.
Believe me, I thought you were that girl. Because I try to do what you want. But you're not that girl.
See, you can say that because you're in power.
Paycheck out. He gave it to you.
He gave it to you. You and them niggas ain't playing dribble nothing. He gave it to you.
That's out of his mercy.
That's my kind of devil right there, boy. My kind of
who
devil.
Who else does it for him?
Right.
I'm not going to bring any black people to the stadium. Is it easy to say that? It's very easy.
crazy.
Right there, so it says, you just do I know I support them and give them food and clothes and cars and houses. Who gives it to them? Does someone else give it to them? Mm-mm. Go to Deuteronomy. Go to the beginning. Go to Deuteronomy 28, the curses. Mm-mm-mm-mm. The devil going in, boy.
Talking like he the Most High, huh?
He like talking like he the Most High. Right? Deuteronomy 28, we gonna go to the beginning and the end. Go to Deuteronomy 28 and woo!
Boy.
Deuteronomy 28:47. So these are my niggas.
That's right, huh?
These are my niggas on my plantation. I take care of these niggas. Right? Yeah. But see, they get that 100 million for 7 years. They think Master done gave them something.
That's right.
Not realizing they give the money right back because food, clothes, cars, houses. Right? Deuteronomy 28:47. Read that.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 47. Because thou servest not the Most High thy power with joyfulness and with gladness of the heart for the abundance of all things.
Right, we just serve the Most High with joyfulness and gladness of heart. Right? Easy, happy to serve him. We should have been. Come on.
Therefore, shalt thou serve thy enemies, which the Most High shall send against thee. In hunger,
I give them their food. Go ahead.
And in thirst.
That's included in food there. Go ahead.
And in nakedness.
And in nakedness, I give them their clothes. Right? Go ahead.
And in want of all things.
And their cars and their houses. And nakedness can also go with houses. And cars is extended in that. Come on. And in want of all things. Food, clothes, cars, and houses. You will serve your enemies. You didn't want to serve the Most High, so now you got to serve the white man. And he give you your food, your clothes, your cars, and your houses. And what did you say? That's how all these devils feel.
Every last one.
From the boss on your job to the damn devil that's paying you $100 million a plane. You a modern day slave. Don't you get it twisted.
Right.
I love every minute of it. Because the Most High is bringing out how this devil really feel about you. Right? And don't tell me this Bible and these curses are not real.
That's right, God.
Right, go ahead.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck.
Yeah, that's the only thing this devil is missing. Might as well get out there and put a damn collar on Doc Rivers' neck.
The contract.
The contract, yeah, the contract. That's the yoke. Right? Come on, I owned you, boy.
That's right.
The uniform, hell, that's the yoke. Right, go ahead.
Until he have destroyed thee.
Until he have destroyed thee. There you go. Right, like you said, that's a good analogy. The contract. That's that yoke of iron upon your neck.
Niggas want that contract.
Because them niggas, they really can't do nothing. And once that contract is up, they finish. And then 5 years, not even 3 to 5 years later, they broke. Because Esau is letting them know, as long as you're praying for me, I give you your food, your clothes, your cars, and houses.
Right.
As long as you're praying for me.
That's right.
But once they are retired, they go broke.
That's right. Huh?
They finished.
Yeah, you made a good point. You said he does give them money because they probably, because he was a real estate guy.
Uh-huh.
Probably owned dealership. Give that money right back to that.
Give it right back to him. Yeah.
Right back to him.
He probably owned the supermarkets.
Yeah,
all that.
All that.
The clothing stores,
right.
All that. Where they go get their tailored suits, they probably got a hand in all that.
Nigga,
you giving me the money. I know a tailor. Nigga, you own that tailor. Right? Every cracker, you own that tailor. All praise to your Howard and your Howard Shack for letting this come out, man. I love it. Dude. I love every minute of it. Dude. Right? So this devil, that was no, let's go to I said a beginning and end. Let's go to Revelation 12. Revelation chapter 12, and we're gonna get the 15th verse. I love every minute of it. This devil, this is a good devil right here. Good devil stuff.
Like them crap.
Good devil stuff, and I like them kind. Mickey Rourke looking cracker. Cracker look like Mickey. Look like an older version of Mickey Rourke. Well, Mickey Rourke is old as hell now anyway. Right, 12:15, Revelation.
Revelation chapter 12, verse 15.
Matter of fact, let me see. Revelation 12:13.
Revelation chapter 12, verse 13. And when the dragon saw that he was cast unto the earth.
And that's another thing. This is prophecy coming into effect too. When Esau, in a spirit, they start to feel that their kingdom is coming down. Right, when the dragon saw that he was cast to the earth, come on.
He persecuted the woman.
They're going to start taking out their anger on Israel, and their true spirit and feelings going to start coming out. Right, come on.
Was brought forth the man child.
That's talking about the nation of Israel. The woman is talking about the nation of Israel. The man child is Yahusha. You go. That's further up in the chapter, but right now we get to the point. Verse 14.
And to the woman were given two wings of a great eagle.
Right. The Lord said unto the woman were given two wings of a great eagle. The woman represents the Israel, and that great eagle and two wings represents she would flee out of the land of Israel in 70 AD and other captivities. Go ahead.
That she might fly into the wilderness.
Right, remember they fled into the interiors of Africa, right? Come on.
Into her place.
Into her place, which eventually we made it to America. Once we fled into Africa, then we were sold off the west coast of Africa, and we made it to our place, which would be America. This would be the main land that Israel would dwell in until the latter time that Yahweh shall deliver us. Right, come on.
Where she is nourished for a time.
She's nourished for a time. Go ahead.
And times.
And times. Go ahead.
And half a time.
Which is around a 350-year period from slavery up until around 1970 when the truth started really coming out and flourishing. Where she's nourished for a time and times and half a time. Come on.
From the face of the serpent.
From who?
The face of the serpent.
From the face of the serpent. I give them their clothes, their food, their cars. So we are actually being nourished by Esau. That links up, Revelation 12 and 14 links up with Deuteronomy 28, 47 and 48, because the Lord said our enemies would give us everything. We would go to them for the want of everything, and it said we would be nourished from the face of the serpent. Everything we get from Esau. The devil, that's why he can brag about
it. Right.
And even if you're an NBA star, them houses, store, cars, you're probably giving it back to him anyway. And he laughing. You thinking you're getting a deal.
Right.
Hey, I got this great house you can buy, man.
Right.
It's right here in the valley in Los Angeles, man. Beautiful home. Come on, man. I give it to you, man. You can get it for still $7 million. Some way, somehow, he's involved in that real estate deal. You're giving the money back to him.
Straight up.
So he owned you, boy.
Straight.